Multi-awarded actress Nora Aunor and veteran opera artist Fides Cuyugan Asensio are finally declared as national artists for 2022 after years of being bypassed, Mario Dumaual reports.
After 8 years of waiting, actress Nora Aunor was finally named as one of the 8 national artists by Malacanang Friday night. She is the recipient of the prestigious honor for film and broadcast arts, along with screenwriter and novelist Ricardo Riquelie and the late director Marilu Diaz-Abaya. Other awardees are Agnes Loxin for dance, the late Salvation Lim Higgins for fashion design, Gemino Abad for literature, Fides Cuyugan Asensio for music, and the late Antonio Tony Mabesa for theater. The new Order of National Artists is based on the joint recommendation of the National Commission for Culture and the Arts and the Cultural Center of the Philippines of exceptional Filipinos who have made distinct contributions to the development of Philippine arts and culture.
My brother is not a pig.
In her moment of vindication, Aunor thanked her family and supporters who struggled to convince the awards jury that she deserves the honor. She was twice bypassed for the National Artist Award in 2014 and 2018. It is also a moment of triumph for the 91-year-old Asensio, who was nominated 4 times through the decades. She told ABS-CBN News, if there's one thing she learned from the long and tedious process of proclaiming national artists, it is never to give up. Asensio also thanked her supporters who stood by her. Lee also paid tribute to all his patrons who stood by him ever since he left his hometown in Daet to pursue his dream in Manila before martial law. Lee said he never stopped writing about the ironies of life to open the minds of the reading public. Loxin thanked all her dancers who embodied her vision as a choreographer to preserve and build up indigenous dancing. Meantime, the family of Higgins told ABS-CBN News that the award will hopefully continue to inspire future generations of Filipino fashion designers. Veteran director Joel Amangan also hailed the proclamation of his longtime friend Mabesa as national artist. He also said that his colleagues Lee, Abaya, and Aunor rightfully deserve the honors. The National Artist Awards will be conferred by Malacanang at a ceremony scheduled later this month. Mario Dumaual, ABS-CBN News.
Now, Elvis-themed weddings in Las Vegas may soon be a thing of the past. Bev Llorente tells us why.
The entertainment capital of the world shook up after some of its renowned wedding chapels received cease and desist letters demanding that they stop using Elvis Presley's image and likeness in their programs. The notices were sent by Authentic Brands Group, which acquired the intellectual property of the King of Rock and Roll in 2013. The cease and desist notices raised concerns from this film wedding business owner. She points out Elvis-inspired weddings are a staple in Las Vegas.
They send it to chapels who are specifically using advertising their chapels as Elvis chapels. All wedding chapels who are actually doing Elvis advertising, Elvis package. Almost all chapels, they have Elvis package. I did too.
De Leon warns over the economic impact of the notices on wedding chapel owners.
I just posted one of my Elvis weddings at the time. I don't think I can do it anymore. I do a lot of them. Yeah, every week I'm always doing Elvis wedding.
De Leon expects a long legal battle between big wedding chapel owners and ABG's Elvis Presley's enterprises.
In my opinion, may mga lalaban because they are making lots of money. Those chapels are making good money. They're going to stop the Elvis weddings. It'll be difficult. There's going to be a fight in court.
Other Las Vegas residents echoed De Leon's concerns over the impact of the cease and desist demand on Las Vegas entertainment industry.
They've been doing it for so long, and just now they just decided to stop it. So I don't understand why they would do that.
ABG apologized for the supposed confusion over its cease and desist notices. It stresses there is no intention to shut down chapels, but rather they are seeking partnerships with small business owners to make sure that Elvis's name, image, and likeness are officially licensed and authorized by the estate. According to the Clark County Registrar's Office, more than 5 million marriage licenses in the county have been issued as of February this year. Elvis-themed weddings are among the most popular weddings in Las Vegas and have been around for decades. Bev Lorente, ABS-CBN News, Las Vegas.